I'm gonna feel that for the next 10 years. I don't remember adventures being so hard on the knees. Forget leg day. I need to strengthen these ankles day. Sure, that's a good thing.
Keep your eyes peeled, Gordon. He should be here any second.
You know how I feel about that name.
Fine, Mordak. Open your eyes. Look alive. Don't screw this up.
Screw this up? Might I remind you, it's my magic keeping you alive.
Yes, and when your magic concocts a working batch of Cosmolotion, I'll praise you. But my patience has grown thin, and I will not tolerate any more mistakes.
Brother, I warned you to stay away from those potions. You wouldn't hear it. I've wasted 30 years of my life trying to duplicate Hagatha's formula. And I'm afraid at this point, I'm ready to move forward or move on.
Is your mind slipping in your golden years? Have you forgotten everything I've sacrificed for you? I took you in from the cold. I saved you from a life of goblin slavery. And you have the gall to complain about 30 measly years?
Well, sometimes it still feels like I'm a slave to a goblin.
Your tongue, Morden, or I will.
Mordak, didn't I extinguish your flame years ago?
I was hiding under the floorboards.
I knew it.
How's the family?
Getting along surprisingly well since you shrunk them.
So glad to hear that.
Uh-huh. You mind moving out of the way? I have some business to attend to with your boss.
Mananin has strictly forbidden me to let you pass. Unless you can convince me that your mind is still strong and quick.
And how might I go about that?
Follow those clearly labeled signposts.
Of course.
Bring me back proof that you have completed each trial, and then I will escort you to Mananin.
I know you won't answer honestly, but I'll ask anyway. Is all this some form of an elaborate trap designed to crush my bones, yank my arms out, or contort my body into a twisted sculpture of death?
No.
Sounds like some good clean fun. I can't figure out if something just broke or snapped back into place. Oh.
Grandpa, are you all right?
I haven't thought about these stories in a long time.
Your ears are all red.
Just give me a moment. This part gets a little wacky. I think I should rest a bit first. You mind getting Grandma in here?
I'll be back after your nap.
Get your rest, dear. I'll be back after dinner.
I'll be fine. Take your time.
Just ring the bell if you need me.
Good night, my love. Remember your promise. Always seek adventure. It's not time yet. I was promised another. I'll fight it, I assure you. But... I'm afraid you're right. You've always been a straight shooter. It's true. The mirror never promised I would live another adventure. Only that my adventure would live on. Just let me say goodbye.
Do you smell that germite, Graham? It's a toxic fume, I'm afraid. One that is said to challenge the strength of the mind.
King Crab? Is that you?
Oh, of course it is. I'd recognize that musk anywhere. It's the smell of legend. And sour cherries, with a hint of mustard. But mostly legend.
Wait, hey, Rambo! Wait, if you're here, does that mean that I am?
Calm down, Sugar Muffin. It's hardly your time yet. Just here to help you navigate your heart.
Oh? And what's my heart telling you? That I need one last piece of advice? Perhaps on outsmarting Manny? Or how I can make sure the legacy of King Graham will come past and it will not be left behind?
Looks like you've got the recipe for legacies mixed up.
Legacies are not about what you leave behind for people. They're about what you leave inside of people.
Oh, your kingdom is best left for the young, Graham.
That's it? You don't have any puns or an item to give me that will eventually solve all my troubles?
We've given all we have to give. You're going to have to figure out the rest of it.
Wake up, Graham. Your mind is strong.
Great. Set that over there, and let me know when you've completed the Trial of Strength. Excellent. Right this way, please.
Well, where is he?
Meow. Charmed, I'm sure.
Are you kidding me? You wish to challenge me like this?
Careful what you say, King. My species has no bearing on my abilities.
I have no problems with cats, Manny, or goblins, or sphinxes. My issues are all with you.
No matter. The duel hasn't even begun. Yet I've already won! Are you aware that you've hand-delivered everything I need to complete another batch of Cosmolotion?
Shocker.
Allow me to explain that you, King Graham the Imbecile, have once again...
Yeah. Wax poetic for two more hours, won't you? Pardon my vacant expression, though. I can barely hear out of my left ear anymore.
Fine. Have it your way. I'll speak with brevity. Long sentences. Drawn out syllables to emphasize a point. Raising my voice. More sesquipedalian words. Overuse of the term moron. And I'll need a hair from your beard for my final ingredient.
See you at sundown.
Meet me at the floating island.
Good chat.
Dad, we brought you some treats. Dad?
Oh. Wow.
We're caught.
Oh.
Dad, say something.
Sorry.
Gwendolyn, go get the nursemaids.
No.
What do you want me to do? What can I get you? You want Mom? Mom!
Story.
Sorry?
No, story.
A story. Help me finish it.
Let's get him back in bed. Grab his feet.
Escape.
I thought I needed one more adventure, one last trophy to hang on these shelves. But the only treasures I need are standing right beside me.
It's okay, Alf. You can stop fighting. It's time.
Before my story is done, you have to finish it.
Me? I don't know how it ends.
I'll help
you. I can't. I'm not ready. Gart should tell it.
Grandfather's passing his hat to you. I think you should take it.
Adventurer to ever live, would do anything in his power to protect his family. As the sun set atop the floating island, Mordak placed the final goblet down for a toxic duel of wits.
That's a great start.
Welcome, friend. I'm glad you could make it.
Mananin restored himself back into human form using the ingredients Grandpa had unknowingly brought to him. But he was weak. The Dremite crystal was the only thing keeping him alive.
Mordak has carefully designed a series of trials to test our wits. Don't worry, he hasn't given me any answers. Some of the goblets have been topped with hypnotic powder. Complete each station individually. If you drink from any of the tainted cups, you will lose and be under my spell, and vice versa.
The goblets have been set up in stations, each with their own rules.
I'll spare you the long speech and just let you read the rules. Ready to prove a goblin is smarter than a man?
There was one clue for each set of goblets. Someone must have thought themselves pretty clever.
You're doing great, sweetheart.
Only one goblet was safe to drink from.
Finish this one, too. Simple, really. Neither of us are hypnotized, so let's continue on. Not really much of a challenge for minds like ours. Mordak, you could have made these a little more challenging. One more to go. Think you can handle it?
Duels at a standstill. Neither competitor could prove they were smarter than the other.
Huh. I was afraid of this, friend. Although you started out as a lanky bumbleward, over the years my trials have conditioned your wits to equal mine. No matter. I have a backup. This flame enchantment will ensure neither of us can leave until the other has perished. How about instead of wits, we engage in a lethal game of chance?
Grandpa had no choice but to play the game. He was trapped and his kingdom was on the line.
I won this set of goblets from a game of wits with Lord Sarwak. One of them holds an irreversible eradicating elixir. A powerful magic that will slowly destroy whatever it touches from the inside out. There are no special markings or any way to puzzle out which is the poison vessel. If there was, I would have slipped it into the batter of your breakfast years ago. What fun would that have been? We'll each take turns choosing a goblet to drink from until they're all gone and the better man wins. You'll drink first.
Grandpa was at a loss. For the first time in his life, the four E's of puzzle solving could not inform his decision. There was no logic to puzzle out. No clues or hints. Just a simple choice of life or death.
I'll ingest this and call it a night. But you know I don't play fair. And you just revealed where the elixir is hiding. You played right into my trap, just like that foolish archer.
Life was spared, and our whole family moved to Avalon. The end.
No, Gwendolyn.
What?
It couldn't have ended like that. You know, if I chose that pump, it would have destroyed the very castle you are standing in. There was only one solution.
He was out of options. Grandpa looked around at the kingdom he created and realized there was only one choice. Grandpa knew the eradicating elixir would slowly destroy him from the inside, but Daventry would live on. That day, Manny was outsmarted in a way he never imagined possible. In a way he could not comprehend.
Ha! Nice move. I'll accept that. But let's see if I can help speed up the effects of that potion. You pushed the thinking man through brute force. I hope you're happy.
You've already won. There's no need to torture him.
It was at that moment, while his body was being jerked through the air, that Mordak was reminded of his first encounter with Grandpa. Manny's enchantments over the castle were broken, and he was never heard from again. Daventry continues to thrive and prosper, thanks to the sacrifices made by King Grant, the greatest grandpa to have ever lived.
Still.
Oh, yes. He heard every word.
Thank you, Gwendolyn. That suits you well.
It was beautiful. You kids have always brought so much joy to your grandfather.
All of his children have.
All right, kiddos, it's bedtime. Say goodnight to Grandma, and I'll tuck you in.
Good night, Grandpa. I love you.
I love you too, God. And I am proud of you.
Thank you. That means a lot.
I just want to say, you're the best Grandpa. And my favorite person in the world. I love you. And I'm so sorry you didn't get your last adventure.
Sweetheart, there is nothing to be sorry about. I now know that all of my adventures will live on forever inside me. As long as you keep telling my stories, they will never die.
Thanks for sharing them with me, Grandpa. I love you.
I love you too, dear. Go. Go get some rest. Wake me in the morning, and we can make some pancakes.
Grandpa.
My sweetheart, Gwendolyn, when you read this letter, you'll already know about the crown I have left for you and why. Please don't worry about me. I lived a long, fulfilling life, and I wouldn't change one decision. I've led this kingdom with all the compassion in my heart, and I've seen that same love in your eyes. I would never force upon you rules and addenda to protect my legacy. You must make your own decisions. I only share my stories in the hope that they would help you down whichever path you choose for Daventry. Go forth and be Queen Gwendolyn the Compassionate, or the Patient, or the Dragon Slayer. Just know that I will always be watching over you and kissing your forehead from the stars above.